Welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today we are going to discuss paper name is Social Movement, and under that module 6 is Social Change and Social Movement. Here we want to discuss how the social change is occurring in the society. What was the basic ethics or bringing the social transformation or social change in the society? So objective of this module is to create an analytical link between the social movement, social structure and social change. The module also offer a brief comprehension on the type of social movement and on globalization and its effect on the movement. So here we want to like to discuss on the social change. Social change is an alternation in the social order of the society. It may means change in the social institutions, social behavior or social relations. Social change may be brought in by the particular social movement or movements. Social movement are, here we can define the social movement. Social movement are collective action aimed at bringing change or resisting the change caused by the external forces. The social movement, both as a concept and as a reality, has a career of its own. It's grow, mature and dissolve. The most social scientists believe that general goal of social movement is it to bring about social change or transformation in the society. In that, what you'll find, see the types of social movement. Some of the sociologists who are focused on the type of movement that we have cited here. Ghanshyamsa talk about the revolts, rebellion and the revolution of the movement. M.S. Rao talking about reformist, transformatory and revolutionary type of movement. P.N. Mukherjee talking about the accumulative, alternative and transformative type of movement. David Alber, alternative, redemptive, reformative and revolutionary type of social movement. So here one of the things we are focusing on, the David Albert model of movement. Here he also talking about the alternative social movement, redemptive social movement, reformatory movements and revolutionary movement is what he is talking about, how the changes occur in the society. So after that we want to focus on what could be the objective of the social movement. First one is explicit and another one is implicit. In explicit, what we want to focus on the specific goal, change in the structure of the society, changing in a certain aspect of the social structure. In the implicit, what we want to focus on the unintended or normative implication that social movement causes to the social structure, irrespective of their failure or success. Movement and change relationship. We want to see how this movement and change relationship occur. Relationship between social movement and social change operate at two directions. First one is social movement do bring change in as much as it's caused by the change in the social structure. Discussion on social movement should account for the interlocking between existing social structure, its historical uprootness and the vision of the future society that its member could share. Now, social change may also precipitate social movement. The rise of industrial capitalism caused a number of social movement, that is a trade union movement, consumer movement, anti-child movement and labor movement and so many other movement which was initiated after the industrial capitalism. The huge number of social movement triggered by the worldwide industrialization, mostly the new social movement. The movement and social change relationship. Now we have to discuss movement and social change relationship. Movement will neither have a potentialities to root out the existing system completely, nor will they succumb to status quo entirely. Social movement is essence, provide a space for confluence between old and new values and a structure. Now what we'll want to see, the independence India is characterized by rapid urbanization and industrialization, planned economic development, passing of a series of social legislation, existing protection to the weaker section, commitment to socialism, secularism and democracy. Each of these elements again influence the origin and the nature and type of and the spread of another type of social movement in the society. Movement based on regional disparity for linguistic state, language movement and even the movement for attainment of the protective discrimination measure are all fueled by the state initiative policies and program to change, which are bringing change in the society. Now the new social movement are not supported by economic classes alone, but by group, not necessarily the rest of earth category, seek new social cultural goal with the element of protest, cry out against the large bureaucratic state apparatus of post-industrial society. New social movement potentially bearers of the new social interest which we are finding. Few movement like a peace movement, transgender gay identity movement, what we'll find, these are the long pending in the society. Transgender, how the we should consider transgender as a equal part of the Indian society. Even we are till today, what we'll finding, even the segregate the transgender, but it's part of the human right. They should be given the equal status in the society. Now the gradually society is considering transgender as a part of the society, because we have faced a long movement. The transgender section has gone for the, and they have fight for their rights. Now even the court, even the society is considering or making the, our lawmakers, they are framing the laws for the transgenders. Same way, what we'll find the human rights before the independence, when there won't be any organizations, even the UN, that there won't be UN when they're talking about the human rights organizations. But after the human rights, which was initiated by the United Nations, when we'll become the member of human rights protocol, when we have signed, then we have started the human rights commission in the center and the state. We have giving the rights of the people in the case of environment, in the case of nuclear protest, in the case of even the land acquisition. We are giving, this is the rights of the people. So even though we have started the protesting or protecting the or giving the rights of the people, that's the basic rights which the human rights is talking about, being a human, whatever the rights we have, that right should be protected, should be given to the people. That right is talking in the human rights discourses. So that right is talked and given to the people of land of the people. So after that, what we'll find, the environmental protection. Even though there is a mass movement in India, there is a protocol, there is a international agreement where we can say that how to protect our environment. Here also what we can say, link with the environment. Here environment is related with the human rights, because these are rights of the people wherever we are living. That the other parties, those who are involved in the spreading the pollution, they shouldn't pollute our environment. Here the rights, the basic right of the individual is incorporated. So here the courts and the government is looking into, and they are taking care of the environment and the human rights. After that, what will focus on the anti-nuclear power in the late capitalist society. Even the anti-nuclear power, when we are going to set up any atomic energy which are produced the electricity, or even the what we'll find in the Jadugora or other atomic, where we can mining activities regarding the nuclear or setting up the atomic station, there also people are protesting, because whenever any project is set up, 10 kilometers radius of that plant, people will affect from the radius. So in that course, government has to see not only to acquire their land and remove them from their, see the natural inhabitant, they have to provide their due care of things. So in that, what we'll find, this rights in that course, the movement has generated, that movement is bring the consciousness or thinking among the those who are the sitting in the power gallery, those who are framing the laws, they start thinking how to give the something to the people, those who have initiated the movement. So new social movement articulate new way of thinking and feeling about the world, about the society. Animal protection, which our woman and child minister Manika Gandhi so many times talking about the animal rights. So here also the movement has started to how to protect our animal also, not only environment or human rights, but we have to focus on the animal rights also. So here what we'll find, that developed widespread sympathy for the non-human species into explicit ideology of outrage. Globalization era, what we'll find, the globalization prepare a ground for movement propaganda through its emphasis on free flow of capitalist. Because what you'll find in the globalization era, we have find the emergence of new things, that is the our new software technologies through the internet, through the other new technology, information can be very easily moved from one country to another country. So here the movement can be generated throughout the world. People can be aware through within a fraction of a second, within a moment or within a days. So today is the new technology, whatever we are using, the mobile, laptop or other WhatsApp group and other software which we are using, it's a one of the, we can say, the positive point of globalization, which brought the consciousness among the people. So it can also brought the movement, social movement, new social movement among the society. It create the awareness among the people. It create the platform for transnational social movement through the global network, facilitate social movement and their agenda, strategies and spreadness, how to people mobilize themselves, how to organize and how to protest against any of these issues. So anti-globalization movement are result of the problem posed by the globalization itself. Even some of the movement which has been started against the anti-globalization, that we can find it. Reaction to the globalization come in the variety form, like nationalist, ethnic uprising, religious fundamentalists, that we can find religious fundamentalists in the form of terrorism. What we'll find? IS, it's what we'll find from the India. Also people are organized themselves. They through the internet, they come through that, what is the work of IS, they trained themselves. We are going from India, they packed their luggage, they went to join the IS. So this is the globalization which brought through the technology and the globalization. People are aware about this fundamentalist method and people can mobilize or train themselves. It may be the positive or negative for the society, but reality is that our youth, they are redefining or they are training themselves through the new medias, I mean the medias and the new softwares. So here what you'll find, the anti-globalization movement are also known as the global justice movement, the global justice and solidarity movement, global democracy movement also it can be called. Anti-globalization protests are triggered against the negative consequences of globalization, which it has been the repercussion of the globalization which brought in the our Indian society. This ideological stances is self-explanatory that they are against the globalization. Example is carnival against the capitalism, the battle of Seattle and the Mumbai protest against the World Social Forum. These are the one of the example of the anti-globalization movement. The positive that the movement are oppositional force against the status quo stand valid when we consider social movement in the context of police state that confine its attention to the protection and security of the citizen. What you'll find, you can see the every 14th Feb, if there is some youth, those who are in favor of organizing the Valentine Day, and some of the section of the society, even along with the police force, if they are going to oppose, maybe vandalize the people or the some of the places where the Valentine's Day are celebrated, what we'll find, this is the reshuffle or the see the what the globalization has brought and the movement which the people try to do it, anti-globalization movement in the form of opposing the Valentine's Day or others day, which in the Indian society we are not going to organize, maybe the Father's Day, Mother Day, Friendship Day, which it is not generally we are see attending as a form of which the West which they are organizing or celebrating as a day. So the growing popularity of welfare state are marked the sea change in the role and significance of the state as a principal agenda of social change and transformation. So contemporary state have replaced their earlier over emphasis on security by welfare state. Welfare here, the state try to give something to the citizens of India, not only providing security to the citizens. They no longer act merely as a police state. So they have not only police state, but they have to work for the welfare of the people. Like we have discussed, see the concept of human rights, animal rights. Here the people are, government has to look after the basic right of the people, that we have to maintain, we have to give basic right to the people. So the increasingly acquiring the image of being a facilitator. So the in the globalization era, the government has to provide as a or work as a role of facilitator. Indian context, what you'll find, the state has in fact inspired to reach out all positive change necessary for the emerging nation state. Then only India can be called as a one of the developing or developed nation. Otherwise, we can't call India as a developed nation. The Indian state has mobilized its vast masses into the collective action, because then only we can initiate. Even in the case of what you'll find, the caste or other mechanism, because the globalization, what will bringing the disparity between the rich and poor, that also we find the anti-globalization forces talking about. It brought the gap between the rich and poor, much more gaps, because the those who are the earlier educated and the more advanced, they are only benefited. Those people who are the deprived or the poor, still they are depriving, they are not benefiting from the globalization. So here the state has to take and work more for the betterment of the citizens. State bureaucracy in India quite often acted as an instrument of change and development. Definitely for the long, this is the role of bureaucracy, or the bureaucracy which are working, linking for the development or instrument for bringing the social transformation in the Indian society. Indian society has experienced several such changes initiated by the state, that we can say the land reform, because what you'll find, the some of the state in India, they thought about or brought the land reform, because it is one of the landmark thing where the transformation of social change come up within the ruler network. But what you'll find, the after the 67 years of independence, some of the state, they won't bring out the land reform. Still we are looking for the land reform which can brought the social transformation in the society. This transformation in the function of the state and mode of its function has tremendous significance for the analysis of social movement in contemporary society. So in that context, what you'll find, state bureaucracy has to work for the welfare and betterment of the people. Any analysis of social movement would surely be incomplete if it missed to address the implication of these changes, dynamics of the state and its functioning upon the social movement. So in the conclusion, we can say social change and social movement are intimate, though not always complementary, because the social movement bring in social change. However, social movement are not the only agent of social change, because social transformation come or social change by different means. Like the if the government is or bureaucracy is ready to frame, or even the lawmakers, they are ready to bring out the law, some of the laws, or if they are going to part of the international agreement, that which we have find in our content, which we are discussing about the land reform, human rights, animal rights. In that sense also, what we'll find, it can brought social transformation, social change in the society. It's not necessary that always there will be a movement. People has to start the movement, then only we can go for the social change. That we can take the example of Indian caste system. Today what we'll find in some of the state, the transformation in the caste system, this is the very silent revolution we can find. It is not the due to the social movement, like caste movement, which has been initiated by the B.R. Ambedkar or other social reformer, that in faces the dismantling of the caste system. But due to the legislation, due to the efforts by the government, due to the gradual work of some of the organization, that will what we'll find, the liberalization, or we can say the flexibility in the Indian caste system. Same way, what you'll find, the concept of human rights, environmental concern, this is maybe the effort by the so many people, not only from the social movement, that all sort of changes or transformation come up in the society, or the new laws which we'll find in the regarding the women. Because in the Indian society, what the women is considered about, but when the law has been passed in 2013, maybe the rape laws not up to the mark. People are, because the what is the law? Law means the create the fear among the people, the among the perpetrator, those who are committing the crime. So through the laws, through the rape laws, even the try to bring out some sort of, or try to control up to some mark the crime rates in the society. So in that sense, we can say not always the movement, but up to some extent, the work of the legislation, work of the lawmakers are also important to bring out the social change, social transformation in the society. So social change also triggers social movement in the form of resistance and maintenance of status quo. That resistance, we can say, in the form of Land Acquisition Act. What you'll find, the land acquisition after the long massive years of resistance after the independence, what you'll find, the new law has been passed in 2014. Then only those people who are the displaced from their land, they are getting the compensation from the Supreme Court or other lower courts. So this is the long drawn process. I mean, the so many fights the people has been fighting for the long years. Now what you'll find, the form of social change, social transformation, because the lawmakers, they also realize, and the bureaucracy also realize, and the policy maker also realize, that people has to give something if you want to do, if you want to mobilize people, if you want to bring the people for the mainstream of society. We have to give something to the common people, we have to give something to the marginalized section of society also. Thank you.